In elliptic curve cryptography, we deal with an equation such as y squared is equal to x cubed plus ax plus b, where a and b are our variable values. So this gives us a curve such as this nice smooth curve. The advantage with it is that if we pick any point on the curve and then project a straight line, we will always cut the curve at some time in the at some time on the curve at another point. So here are some examples of elliptic curves. So in this case, we'll try this one here, which is this curve here, fairly standard curve. Y squared is equal to x cubed plus 7. So a is 0 and b is 7. So we just plot that one and it looks like this. Okay, so we get this shape because when y is 0, when x is 0, it becomes 0 plus 7. So y is equal to the square root of 7. So that gives us this value here, roughly 2 point something. And we also get a negative, the same negative value because we're dealing with the square. So we get a plus and a negative value. Some of the other curves that we can have a look at, this one here. Okay, so we're only seeing a little bit of the curve there. Okay, so that's the curve, but in elliptic curve cryptography, we have integer values and we convert them into other integer values. So we end up with a point on our elliptic curve, which is an integer value. So our values actually look like this. And the reason for this is that we have a mod of a prime number. So our y squared plus is equal to x cubed plus 7 mod 37 looks like this, because these are the valid points that we have in the elliptic curve. So here they are here. This is for 0 and 7 and a prime of 37. So these are the first 20 points that we have here. And we'll just check that that's the case. So we'll take our Python program and we'll go for an x value equal to 3, and then we'll print x cubed plus 7 mod 37, so 34. So we now must find a value y squared mod 37 to equal the same value. So in this case we can see down here it's 16 because we've used a little Python program to do this, but we'll just check that this is the case. Y squared mod 37 equals, hopefully it's 34, and that's the case. So we'll try the next point, which is 4 and 16, this point here, and we'll do the same again. It's also 34, and as we've seen before, that's 34. So the next point is at 5, so in this time we get this value 21, and our point here is 13. So that means that 13 squared mod 37 is also 21. Okay, so we see sometimes that we can't find a value for the x value for our y value. So there are gaps in the points that we actually have where we can't find an integer x and y value. Okay, so we'll try a couple of examples and see what our points look like. So this one is mod 101. There we go. Okay, there's the points. So so because we're using a finite field, the values will range from 1 to 101. So we see the values are larger. We'll try this one. Larger mod, this time the y axis will be much larger. Okay, and there's our distribution here. Those are the first 20 points that we get. And here is another curve. So we can actually see that the curve looks nothing like the nice elliptic curve that we saw here. And the reason for that is because we're using a finite field with our mod number here. Okay, so here we are, first 20 points takes us up to about 39 there. So it's only about 1 and 2 points are valid points. And that's the reason that 256, that's the reason that 128-bit AES is equivalent to 160-bit elliptic curve, because we miss out about half of the points, or we miss out quite a few points, which means that we need larger key sizes to be the equivalent of a method which has the full key range. Okay, so that's provided an introduction into what an elliptic curve really looks like in elliptic curve cryptography.